I like to draw an analogy to a program from the 1960s. It's a program called the X-15. X-15 was a rocket plane of which three were built. The three X-15 vehicles flew out of Edwards Air Force Base over a period of about 10 years. And during that time, they flew 199 times. That means once roughly every 18 days. The amount of data that was gathered in that program is absolutely amazing. That's the model we need to be thinking of. Repeated flight test every couple of weeks, not every few months, or in some cases, every few years, if we're to succeed in hypersonic research development and fielding.
The X-15 is arguably the most successful hypersonic test program ever flown. One X-15 flight costs 3% of building a whole new X-15. It was a fully reusable air launch vehicle translating directly into affordability. And that's what's missing from what we're doing today in the United States.
So there's no fixed definition of hypersonics. We generally use it in regard to flight in excess of about 5 times the speed of sound. That's Mach 5. The shock waves normally form on a supersonic aircraft are pressed very close to the aircraft. Skin friction effects in the atmosphere are so significant that the surfaces become really hot, chemical reactions become important, and you need high temperature materials with which to build a vehicle. Hypersonics has a range of applications, everything from weapons to aircraft to access to space. It's really the next step in military technology. We have relied up to now in modern warfare on stealth capabilities. Other countries are developing their own stealth capabilities. They're developing ways to penetrate stealth. Next is speed, and the combination of speed and maneuverability that hypersonic brings is going to be critical to the future of warfare. Now, the challenge that we face is other countries have also figured this out, building on work that was done in the United States. We did their homework for them, and they have moved to not only research and develop systems, but are now deploying these capabilities. Most recently in Ukraine, the Russians bragged about using hypersonic missiles. And we, the United States, are still in the research and development phase. We have not deployed yet. So we're in a race, and it's a race that right now our peer competitors seem to be winning, unless we step up our game. But beyond that, most of our hypersonic flight testing has been done over the Pacific Ocean, which means when we're done with the test, we splash whatever the article is in the ocean, never to be seen again.
Stratolaunch is the only company that's offering a reusable system. Talon-A is a Mach 6 class vehicle. We can fly this vehicle autonomously. We can give it a trajectory beforehand for our customers who are interested in how do the materials behave at those temperatures. How do the sensors behave when they're trying to look through a boundary layer in a shock wave? Things that they really can't simulate on the ground. So it allows the designers to mature technologies, gain a lot of information in the hypersonic environment, and get the payload back to study it. No other system can boast that. Okay, I got it.